Hello friends, good morning and welcome to the EduSite Network. Our topic of discussion is part of our ongoing series on film studies, and friends, today we are going to take up a continuation of our previous lecture. We talked about Indian cinema and the partition of India, and friends, we have already covered part 1 and 2, and today's lecture will form part 3 of the same. So of course, just to give you a heads up on how to have a look at the first two is to go on YouTube and go to the channel of CEC on YouTube, and you will be able to retrieve the lectures. So friends, for this we have with us in the studio same subject expert Dr. Manoj Sharma, Assistant Professor, Department of History, Kirorimal College, University of Delhi. And with this very brief introduction, I welcome sir to the studio.
Thank you
for coming.
Very good morning to all the viewers. And as told to you that we have discussed in the two episodes, Indian cinema and the partition of India, that how a number of films on partition of India, they were being made, what were the concerns in the partition of India, the various historical debates, as well as how arts, including literature, cinema, they tried to portray the partition of India. And we were talking about Garam Hawa, which was made in 1973 by M.S. Satyu, and how this film is considered to be one of the most important portrayals of partition of India, because the approach was very realistic in nature. As discussed, that film was set in Agra, and how two of the brothers, one decides to go to Pakistan and the other one, who stays in India, has some kind of a dilemma whether to stay in India or not. M.S. Satyu was closely associated with IPTA, Indian People's Theatres Association, and the other actors like Balraj Sahani, who played the role of the protagonist in the film, also belonged to IPTA as well. And Farooq Sheikh, who made his debut with this film, was also acting in some of the IPTA plays. At the same time, Shaukat Azmi, who played an important role in the film, she also was associated with IPTA. So what we see is that one of the most sincere portrayals with regard to partition could be seen in this film. At the same time, what we also see is that a number of films which were connected with the theme of partition or the theme of the portrayal of Pakistan could be seen in the 90s. A number of films, they were being made on the issue of partition. As we see that partition was not taken up initially when partition was effected in 1947, and very few films, they were being made till the making of Garam Hawa in 1973. And Yash Chopra's film Dharmputra, which was made by him, that also became some sort of a failure. It was a flop. And filmmakers, they did not venture into the themes which were very sensitive from the point of view of the experiences of people with regard to partition. But later, some of the filmmakers, they ventured into these themes, and some of the films like Tamas, etc., they were also being made. So what we see is that apart from the films, a lot of literature was also connected with partition. Sadat Hasan Manto, Ismat Chugtai, and later Salman Rushdie, what they wrote about partition, the experiences of partition, that was also talked about in the literature. And at the same time, these people, they also contributed with regard to the cinema as well, as Garam Hawa was based on Ismat Chugtai's story. So what we see is that literature was also reflecting the kind of trauma and displacement of partition, and how this displacement and trauma of partition was reflected in cinema and other arts was also significant from the perspectives of how media in that way, or arts in that way, was trying to project the tragedy of partition. So what we see is that one of the TV series like Buniyad, which was telecast on television in 1986-87. It was also associated with the theme of partition. And this drama series was made by Ramesh Sippy and Jyoti Swaroop. And these were the people, those who were associated with the production of the series. And his father was also one of the refugees who came from Pakistan. So they understood the kind of dilemma the people had with regard to partition. And it was scripted by Manohar Shyam Joshi, and the kind of problems with which people were afflicted during the partition of India and its aftermath was discussed in this series. And it was shown on DD National. What we see is that the Delhi Doordarshan network was engaged. And in those times, you did not have cable television network and DTH, which came in 1990s. So Doordarshan was the main TV channel on which people banked upon, and a number of serials during that particular period, maybe they were associated with the mythological themes, or Tamas, as was initially produced as a TV series. It was a telefilm which was telecast on Doordarshan in a number of episodes, and they also tried to show the kind of partition experiences of the people. So what we see is that how partition and literature, they were being linked. Amrita Pritam's Pinjar, on which film was also made later, and Rahi Masoom's Raza, Aadha Gaon, they represent the experiences of the subaltern Indian Muslims in a village called Ganguli, and the distinct take on the vacuity of the high politics. So what we see is that the literature is trying to portray the partition in some way, and some of the fictional writings in the form of stories, they were also written during this particular period. So some of these literature that was being used in terms of producing films, that became quite popular during this particular period. And the people, those who were associated in terms of writing literature, like Saadat Hasan Manto and Ismat Chugtai. Saadat Hasan Manto wrote a number of stories and novels also, and some of his scripts in the film, they were also written by him. And his writings, they were closely associated with the partition of India. He was a film and radio script writer as well as a journalist. And he was also associated with the Progressive Writers Association, or PWA. Though the kind of writings with which Manto was associated, he was tried for obscenity several times by the court. And some of the films with which he was associated in terms of script writing was Aath Din, Chal Chal Re Naujawan, and Mirza Ghalib. And Mirza Ghalib was later released in 1954. Saadat Hasan Manto, he migrated from India to Pakistan, and Ismat Chugtai decided to live in India, and she died in 1991. And Saadat Hasan Manto, he died in 1955. Till that time, the kind of writings with which Saadat Hasan Manto, they were considered to be even blasphemous in that context. And at the same time, the kind of cases which were fought in various courts in India as well as in Pakistan against Saadat Hasan Manto were reflective of the kind of writings with he was associated, as many of the writings of Saadat Hasan Manto as well as later Ismat Chugtai, they were being considered to be in a way against the conservative orthodox beliefs of the people in that way. And the people, those who were conservatives or orthodox, they did not like the kind of writings of Manto and Ismat Chugtai. And she was also involved in terms of bans on her work, as well as she was also tried in a court for obscenity. Ismat Chugtai was born in 1915 and she died in 1991. And the kind of themes she explored in her writings were feminine sexuality, middle class gentility, and other evolving conflicts in modern India. So these were some of the themes which were explored by Ismat Chugtai. And she was a very outspoken kind of a person, as well as some kind of writings which she was involved, they were considered to be controversial in nature. And what we see is that She also attended the first meeting of the Progressive Writers Association, and Progressive Writers Association was formed in 1936, and this association was involved with the movement where the writers, they had to be very progressive in nature and the kind of radical stance which they have to take, and she was also associated with this. She married Shahid Latif, who directed a film called Ziddi in 1948, and later some of the films were also made by him. And she was closely involved in his work with regard to cinema. Her writings, Angare and Lihaf, they were banned in South Asia because of the kind of themes of reformism and the kind of feminist content which offended the conservatives. And she was also associated in terms of writing the story of Garam Hawa. So what we see is that Ismat Chughtai was very, very outspoken. At the same time, the kind of themes with which she was dealing, those themes were considered to be in a way radical in nature, and the orthodox and the conservative elements, they did not like the kind of themes on which she was writing. But she continued in her work, and she was a educated lady. She studied in Aligarh Muslim University, and thereafter she was associated in terms of writing of stories and writing of scripts of films. And from that perspective, she wanted to bring some kind of reform within the societies with regard to women, that how women in the conservative Muslim household, they were being treated, and how some kind of freedom should be given freedom should come to these women. Richard Attenborough's Gandhi was made in 1982, and this was a film which was based on the life story of Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi was considered to be the father of the nation, and how Ben Kingsley, who played the title role, justified the role of Gandhi in this film. At the same time, what we see is that Gandhi, he was a practicing Hindu, and he also embraced other faiths like Christianity and Islam, is being depicted in the film. And Gandhi was opposed to the idea of partition in that way, that Pakistan should be created out of India, and he believed in the unity of India that way. And he led a number of non-violent, non-cooperation movements, and the Gandhi's movements against the British, and these kind of movements which Gandhi launched against the British could also be shown in, could also be seen in the film. So what we see is that Gandhi was a champion of Hindu-Muslim unity in that context, and he never desired or wished that India should be divided and partition should take place. And when India attained its independence, Gandhi was there in a village in Noakhali in West Bengal, which was one of the worst affected areas. And Gandhi wanted to bring peace to the region in that way, that he did not want Hindus and Muslims, they should fight in any way. And the kind of movements which he launched, maybe the non-cooperation movement in 1920, civil disobedience movement in 1930, and Quit India movement in 1942, all these three important movements of Gandhi, apart from the kind of humanitarian work and the community work in which Gandhi was involved, what we see, there was a streak of secularism in Gandhi's ideals as well as practices, and he did not in any way want that Hindus and Muslims, they should have any kind of conflict. Rather, he also made a plea that Indian government should provide a lot of some kind of money to the Pakistan, so that they are able to in a way look after the economy. And these were some of the things which were later criticized by some of the leaders, as they did not want to give any kind of compensation to Pakistan in terms of monetary help. So what we see is that during this particular period, the kind of films, they were not only talking about the issues of women, not only issues of uprootment, but they were also dealing with the kind of politics which was there, and the kind of political leaders, those who were associated with this kind of politics. And some leaders of Congress like Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Patel, a number of films, they were being made on them, as well as a Pakistani film which was made on Muhammad Ali Jinnah, Jinnah, who was considered to be the person who was associated with the birth of Pakistan. And one of the films which was associated with the partition tragedy was Tamas, which was made by Govind Nihalani, and it was based on the Bhisham Sahani's novel of the same name. And it was reflecting the kind of partition tragedy of the masses, as well as the kind of communal overtones could be seen in this film. The violence and the bloodshed which was shown in the film was also reflective of the partition tragedy, and how the people, they migrate from one area to another, that shows the displacement of the people and how they become refugees. And with that, the feeling of rootlessness which they felt was also evident in this series called Tamas, which was made in 1987. So what we see is that from a perspective in which how a small incident could lead to great tragedies could be seen in this particular film, the kind of suspicion which was there in the minds of the people, that how a person is being asked to slaughter a pig because that was required by a thekedar, and how that pig could be found near a mosque, and which led to some sort of a communal situation, and how the people, those who were the political leaders of that particular area, they tried to diffuse the communal violence which was there, and how it also led to the kind of displacement of people realizing that they will not be able to stay in that area because the kind of partition violence, or the kind of violence in the form of riots which have taken place in that particular area. So the communal amity or the harmony of Hindus, Muslims and the Sikhs, that was disturbed, and how people, they had to flee or run away from the areas in which they had been living for ages, that could be seen. At the same time, how women, they jump into the wells so that they were able to save their honor was also shown in this film. And this scene became some sort of an iconic kind of a scene in that context, where women, they had to jump into wells, and this was not done at one place, but at different places these kind of scenes, they were being enacted. It became some sort of a reality during that particular period, and how these kind of women, they were also being rehabilitated, how the exchange of women took place between India and Pakistan, and these women, they were being rehabilitated by the government, and at the same time some kind of calls were also made to the young men of different communities, that they should in a way agree to marry these women, those who had been victims of partition, and how exchange of women after the partition of India, it also took place by some sort of a discussions between the two governments. And this film also got the Nargis Dutt Award for the best feature film on the national integration. So what we see is that Tamas, which was made by Nihalani, was considered to be some sort of work in which it was given an award, that how it was in a way integrating the Indians, and how the theme, the tragedy of partition, we could learn from the tragedy of partition and see to it that such kind of incidents may not be repeated in the future. But that's a different thing, that the lessons have not been learnt when we see the kind of violence and the kind of riot situation we see even now. The intention of the filmmakers is to show that people learn from these kind of experiences so that these kind of tragedies, they may not occur in future. Sardar was another film which was made in 1993, and in this film Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, Patel's work was being shown, and how Sardar's work in the context that he was able to get all the princely states to join the Union of India. At the same time, the handling of problems which were posed by the princely states of Kashmir, Junagadh and Hyderabad was also shown, and his differences with Nehru, and how they worked together after the death of Mahatma Gandhi was also shown in the film. At the same time, the film ends with Sardar saying that today from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, there is one independent nation. So what we see is that from the political perspectives also, some of the films they were being made apart from Gandhi, apart from Nehru, apart from film on Jinnah, this film called Patel on Sardar Patel with the title of Sardar was also made, in which Paresh Rawal enacted the central role. And this film in a way was trying to portray the kind of problems which were associated with regard to the partition violence, as well as the refusal of certain states of India to not to join the Union of India, and how the work of Sardar Patel within that context, in which he was able to influence all these states to accede to India, was also shown. At the same time, the political life of Sardar Patel, where he had differences with Nehru with regard to the policy matters, and at the same time, after the death of Nehru, they worked together within the cabinet, working as the Home Minister of India, and tackling the various problems with which India was afflicted after 1947, they were being shown, and how he was able to create some kind of a nation or a country where the kind of violence which was there, where a number of states which were not ready to accede to India, and such kind of a civil war kind of a situation where there was a lot of disorder, some kind of a discomfort within the society, that was being shown in the film. So the role of the political leadership within the context of the independence, where they had to create an India where some kind of order existed and some kind of peace which was to be brought about within the context of the partition of India, which brought a lot of misery to the people. One film which I'd like to talk about is Jinnah, which was made by Jamil Dehlavi. It was a Pakistani film, and it was talking about life of the founder of Pakistan. It was released in UK and Pakistan. Film talks about role of Jinnah in the Muslim League and the political journey of two nations, and the massacre of people in migration, and how Pakistani troops they move into Kashmir, which leads to the war between India and Pakistan. So what we see that there is a perspective in which how Jinnah became central to the demand of Pakistan. Jinnah, who was closely associated with the Indian National Congress in his early years, considered to be a nationalist in his early years, and how he turns himself into a communalist, and how the demand of Pakistan became synonymous with the kind of political activities of Jinnah, and how Muslim League also became synonymous with the activities of Jinnah. And in the Lahore session in 1940, the demand for Pakistan was made, and how Rehmat Ali, who in 1936, a Cambridge scholar, he conceptualized the idea of Pakistan with different states which were there in India, and how poet Iqbal also supporting Jinnah in that framework for the demand of Pakistan, and how Jinnah, who was not orthodox in his beliefs and approach, led to the creation of Pakistan, and the two nation theory which flowered during the colonial rule was in a way realized with the help of Jinnah. And this kind of a political journey in which Jinnah was able to carve out a new state of Pakistan out of India was touched upon in this film. And later how the kind of conflict over Kashmir between the two countries, India and Pakistan, was also shown. But at the same time, this division of the country also led to the partition, and the partition experiences of so many people, those who were affected, was also shown from a certain perspective. Another film which I'd like to talk about is Train to Pakistan, which was made by Pamela Rooks, and it was adapted or based on the Khushwant Singh's novel, which was in 1956, and the novel was of the same name, with the title of Train to Pakistan. And it was also set in the 1940s, in 1947 with the partition of India. And the film talks about the love affair of Jagga and Nooran. Jagga is a village gangster who is in love with a Muslim girl, and the role played by Nirmal Pandey, and how this kind of a love affair between two people of different communities, it was being played upon when a train comes in the village where a number of Sikhs, they have been killed. So this kind of exchange of trains during that particular period, where trains coming from India to Pakistan and from Pakistan to India, they were coming with so many people, those who had died in some of the trains, they were completely massacred by the people of the other community. And this in a way further enraged the other community, those who saw the dead bodies of the people of their own religion. So this kind of communal frenzy, this kind of fanaticism for one's religion was aggravated during these particular times when such kind of trains, they went one from one area to another. So this was also shown in this particular film, and how when this kind of train came, the village became some sort of a battleground where all sorts of problems they became apparent, and how police was unable to stop that kind of surge of aggression, and the administrative apparatus was not able to handle the kind of problems which were there with regard to law and order. And now the decision with that regard was left to Jagga, because now people with contradictory loyalties could be seen. And Jugat Singh or Jagga, he tries to convert himself and tries to regain peace for his village. So what we see is that these kind of films, which were based on the partition theories, partition experiences, which were based on novels, they were being made in 1990s, and Train to Pakistan by Pamela Rooks was one such film which was made. At the same time, during this particular period, we see there was a film 1947 Earth by Deepa Mehta, which was made during this particular period. And this film was made on Bapsi Sidhwa's novel Ice Candy Man, in which Amir Khan, Akshay Khanna and Nandita Das, they played the central characters. And the story is set in Lahore, which was during and before and during the 1947. And our Hindu woman Shanta, played by Nandita Das, Dilnawaz, played by Amir Khan, who is an ice candy man, and Hassan, a masseur, Rahul Khanna, and how both these fellows are in love with Shanta, that was also being shown. But how their lives, they also change with partition, with the kind of changes which they come, which come in their lives, all the three characters, their lives change with the arrival of partition. How the kind of atmosphere of suspicion that comes into their lives, and with that kind of suspicion, their lives also changes during this particular period. So these were some of the films which were made in 1990s, which were dealing with the issue of partition. Mahesh Bhatt's film Jakhm was also made in 1998, though the film was not directly associated with the partition, but the kind of communal situation which was there at different times in the country, even after the partition of India, was reflected in the film, as the film talks about the journey of a man called played by Ajay Devgan, his name is Ajay in the film, and later he realizes that his mother was a Muslim, and she had secretly married a Hindu, and she was living as a Hindu, and how her mother is being burnt by a group of rioters when she was leaving a temple, and she was in a critical state. And it was the desire of the mother that she should be given some sort of a proper burial, so that when she was not able to meet her better half in this on the earth, but she will be able to meet her better half in heaven. And how one of the sons who has turned into some sort of a fanatic and has become some sort of a communal person, and later when he realizes that his mother was a Muslim, and later he agrees when some sort of a politics is being played within the film that that his mother would be buried. So this kind of a dilemma could be seen in this film, which was also in a way considered to be some sort of a film which was associated within the framework of the communal relations. Shaheed-e-Mohabbat Bhutta Singh was a Punjabi film which was made in 1999, and this film was based on the real love story of Bhutta Singh and Zainab. As Bhutta Singh is a retired army personnel, he comes to his village. He was unmarried, he was in his 30s, and he was able to locate a woman who was chased by some people, and he saves that girl. And this girl is a Muslim girl. Both of them, they fall in love and they get married also. But when women, they were being deported in the later part, the women, those who were left behind, and later they were being deported to their respective countries. Zainab is one who's being deported to Pakistan because uncle of Bhutta Singh did not like her to be here because he wanted the property of Bhutta Singh in his name if he will remain some sort of a bachelor. And how, when she goes, Bhutta Singh also goes to Pakistan in search of her, and how he dies there when he is not able to get back Zainab. So this love story of real love story was had some kind of shades in another film which was made later with Sunny Deol in 2001, and which also became quite popular, which we will discuss in the course of the discussion. Hey Ram was another film which was made in 2000, and this film was written, directed and produced by Kamal Haasan. He also acted as the protagonist in the film. The film is also centered on India's partition and the account of the murder of Mahatma Gandhi by Nathuram Godse. And it also shows the kind of violence during partition. Suveer Kaul has talked about partition, and he also refers to the jingoism which is displayed during India-Pakistan cricket matches even after the partition of India, and how these India-Pakistan matches, they were completing the unfinished business of partition. So how the cricket audience, it became jingoistic even in these matches, and it was thought that the unfinished business of partition will be decided on the cricket field. So all these kind of issues, they have been talked about. And in Hey Ram, we see a lot of violence, that how the central character of the film, how his wife is being raped and murdered in the religious frenzy of partition, and how he himself engages himself in the murder of the people, those who had murdered his wife. So these kind of ideas, they were being shown in the film, and in the later part, how this fellow reforms himself, and how he believes in the philosophy of ahimsa of Mahatma Gandhi, that was also shown in the film. Pinjar was a film which was made in 2003. Chandraprakash Dwivedi was the director of the film, and the film was based on the Punjabi novel of the same name, which was written by Amrita Pritam. And this film won the National Film Award for the best feature film on national integration. The film centers on the abduction of women, that how because of a personal feud, a Hindu woman was being abducted by a Muslim, and later she had to lead a life with him forever, and even given a chance that she can come back to his family fold, she refuses and adapts to her life. The film is to her own life with a Muslim. And how during this particular period, what we see is that during the communal riots in the village, how people, they had to migrate. And even in those communal times, in those turbulent times, how she even helps the sister of her prospective husband, because her prospective husband's sister, she also got lost during the partition migration, and how she, with the help of her Muslim husband, is able to locate the girl and hands over the girl to her prospective husband. When the prospective husband says that he is even ready to marry even now, that she should come back to India and she should stay with him, she refuses to go to India and says that now she has a future there, as she has converted to religion, and how she adapts with her own situation. So this was not only happening within the context of India, it was also happening within the context of Pakistan as well, that how many women, those who remained in India, they were being converted or they remained with their perpetrators, those who committed violence on them, those who committed physical abuse on them. So these kind of changes could be seen, these kind of things could be seen during this particular period. And another film which I would like to talk about is Khamosh Pani, which was in Punjabi. It was a Pakistani film which was made in 2003, and it was a French and German production by Sabiha Sumar, and it was about a widowed mother and her young son, and the film was set up in 1970s, and how a Hindu woman who got converted to Islam, and in the later part her brother comes to search for her. So what we see in this particular film is that there's a woman who's a widow who has to convert to Islam because she was being abused during the partition riots, and she also marries the person who had abused her, and her son believes her he believes or converts himself into some sort of a fanatic, and later this kind of truth is in a way exposed in the village when the brother of the woman comes in 1970s, and he realizes that there was his sister during the carnage of partition, and she must have been alive because she ran away, she was not murdered. So when he tries to inquire about her and even find her, this creates some sort of a situation in a village where her son is not happy with that kind of situation, and she is being forced in a way that she should go and draw water from the well of the village, and she should recite the verses of the Quran. So all such kind of things, they happen and in the film, and basically the film talks about the situation of a woman, that how she had to convert and how all her life she had to adjust. So this was reflective of the kind of situation in which a number of women found themselves. Another important film which I would like to talk about was Gadar, Ek Prem Katha, which was made in 2001. And this film was also set up in Pakistan, in the partition of India, and how the protagonist goes to Pakistan to find his lady love. The story was of a truck driver, Tara Singh, played by Sunny Deol, and who falls in love with a Muslim girl during the partition riots, played by Amisha Patel, and her name was Sakina in the film, who was from an aristocratic family. And when he saves that girl in the partition riots, both of them, they marry. And after their marriage, in one of the advertisements, she is able to realize that her father, played by Amrish Puri, is in Pakistan. And she sends them a message, and they send her a ticket, and she alone goes to Pakistan after her marriage. And when she is not being allowed to come from Pakistan, then her husband, Sunny Deol, and her child, they go to Pakistan to find her. They are not able to locate her in some way, and when they are able to locate, it was very difficult for them to get her back because she belonged to a very aristocratic kind of family which was politically connected. And how the conflict was enacted in Pakistan could be seen. And when her husband, who illegally goes to Pakistan with his own son so that they are able to get her back, is being held by a Muslim friend of his. So this kind of some sort of a Pakistan bashing could be seen in the film, because the kind of dialogues which were there, how the protagonist is vociferous in his portrayal, and the dialogues are fierier in that context, and the accompanying violence is also very brutal. As you can see on the screen, the kind of blatant jingoism and the excessive violence which was displayed by Sunny Deol as the leading protagonist, and the Amrish Puri who has played the role of a Muslim leader, could be seen in this film. And earlier what we used to see is that Pakistan was not referred to as a terror patronizing state, rather films they were talking about in terms of, they were not directly referring to Pakistan as a terror promoting state, rather they were talking in the context of the neighbor, how a neighbor state is doing all such kind of things. But the nefarious activities of the intelligence agency of Pakistan, ISI, and the kind of terror with which they were associated, they were reflected in the films which were made during this particular period. And the kind of linkages of Pakistan and the ISI, they were being shown in a number of films during this particular period. The list of films could be seen on the screen as well. You can see Hindustan Ki Qasam in 2001, 16 December in 2002, Maa Tujhe Salaam in 2002 again, Hero Love Story of a Spy in 2003, Kayamat in 2003. So all these kind of films which were made, they were showing that how Pakistan was being promoting terror in India, and how some the leading protagonist in the film, they were trying to avert any kind of danger to India, and how through various kind of storylines, these kind of films, they were being projecting that how Pakistan as a terror promoting state was there in India. And these portrayals were in a way bold in nature, because they were directly referring to the nefarious activities of Pakistan, and these were some of the portrayals which could be seen in 2000s and thereafter in the new decade of the 21st century. One of the films which I'd like to talk about, which were dealing with riots, though it was not directly based on the partition of India, but it became quite popular, was Bombay, made by Mani Ratnam. And it was dealing with the Hindu-Muslim relations, that how love relations between a Hindu boy and a Muslim girl, and they were how they were living their lives in Bombay, and suddenly with the riots in Bombay in 1993 and thereafter, how it changed their lives. And the film was awarded the National Film Award and the Narges Dast Award for the best feature film on national integration, because whatever the kind of situation the film exhibited, but it also talking about the communal amity, that how the relations between the two communities could be solved by, in a way that they get close to each other, and how humanism was much more relevant in every times. There was another film which was also associated with terror, was Fiza, which was made by Khalid Muhammad, and the story revolves around Fiza Karishma Kapoor. That character was played by her, and her brother Aman, played by Hrithik Roshan, who disappeared during the 1993 Bombay riots, and how he got associated with the terrorist group, and she is able to locate him, and she is the one who finally kills him when there is no option. Her brother, he tells her that she should kill him, because there is no alternative. So some of the films which were associated in terms of riots and violence with the bold themes, they were being made during this particular period. Mission Kashmir was another film which was made by Vidhu Vinod Chopra, and which was also associated with the question of terrorism during this particular period. So all such kind of cinema which was talking about the issues of Hindu-Muslim relations and terrorism could be seen during this particular period. There was another film by Govind Nihalani with the title of Dev, which was made in 2004, and the role of the protagonist was played by Amitabh Bachchan. Fardeen Khan and Kareena Kapoor, they also acted in the film, and the film showed that how riots, how the people, they were being killed in the name of religion during the riots, and the role of the administrative machinery. It also showed the idea of the conscience of bureaucracy, and at the same time the futility of the violence. So film is talking about all these kinds of issues, where how the administrative machinery, when it plays a role where their conscience is clean, can do their best in terms of preventing the riots, and how their bureaucracy has to be in order, how their intelligence network should be in such a way, and at the same time their conscience is also very clean, so that they are able to tackle the riots in a very objective manner. And at the same time the futility of the violence was also shown, that how violence is futile in nature was shown in the film. There was another film with the title of Deewar, Let's Bring Our Heroes Home or Back, directed by Milan Lutharia. And this film was based on the adaptation of the escape of the Indian Army's prisoners of war during the Indo-Pakistani War of 1971. And how Major Ranveer Kaul, played by Amitabh Bachchan, who is a prisoner of war, and who was captured along with 50 soldiers by the Pakistani soldiers in 1971, war with India and Pakistan. And how his son, Major Kaul's son, Gaurav, played by Akshay Khanna, he tries to go on a rescue mission 33 years later, and how he is helped by Sanjay Dutt, or the role of played by Sanjay Dutt with the role of Khan, and how he Khan had earlier escaped from the same prison, and how they finally succeed. So this film was based again on the warlike kind of a situation, and how this film, which was made in 2004, was tackling the issue of the prisoners of war, that how prisoners of war, they should be set free, and how they have that kind of right where they should come back to their homes, that was being shown in this film. There was another film with the title of Zameen, which was again tackling the issue of violence, and which was also tackling the issue of terrorism, that how Pakistani terrorists, which were backed by Pakistan, they attacked some kind of a building in India, and how their mastermind is being captured by Ajay Devgan, who is an army officer, and how later Ajay Devgan and Abhishek Bachchan, both of them, they in a way try to salvage the situation when an Indian plane is being in a way hijacked by the terrorist. And when these terrorists, they hijack the Indian plane, they want that the person who has been the mastermind of the attack on the parliament, the ringleader played by Baba Zaheer Khan, played by Mukesh Tiwari in the film, he should be released. And how, when his release is being sought in that particular period, how they play an important role during the film. And this was one of the highlights, and this film also became quite popular in that sense, that it was linked to some kind of real hijacking of an Indian plane which took place. So, but also it was linked to the way the Israeli army their special squad took care of one of the hijackings in 1970s, 80s. So what we see is that all such kind of films which were dealing with different issues, they were being made, how this kind of the issue of terrorism, it became quite important in the year 2000. Another film which was some sort of a breath of fresh air was Veer Zara, which was based on India and Pakistan's conflict, and shows the romance of an Indian Air Force pilot and a Pakistani woman. And the film shows that the sympathetic portrayal of the love across borders. And there's a lot of emphasis on love and brotherhood in the film. So this film was some sort of a departure from the earlier films, which were showing the kind of the terrorist side. And Veer Zara was made by Yash Chopra. And how in this film, a person who has been wrongly convicted in a Pakistani jail, and he is in a jail for nearly 22 years. And when the case is being reopened, his case is being fought by a Pakistani lawyer. And that Pakistani lawyer is able to show that he was innocent, and he has been languishing in a Pakistani jail. On he has been shown to be some sort of an Indian spy, and he was not a spy, rather he came to Pakistan in search of his lady love. So what we see is that finally both the characters, they meet in the end. Another film was Midnight Children, which was made by Deepa Mehta, and this film was based on the novel which was written by Salman Rushdie, and it got a number of awards also, as you can see. And there was some sort of a controversy which was associated with the film, in the context that it showed or portrayed former Prime Minister Indira Gandhi in negative light. So what we see is that these kind of films, they were being made, and there was a film Bhag Milka Bhag, which was again a biopic based on the life of Milka Singh, one of the greatest athletes of India, and how during the partition times Milka had to flee from Pakistan, and he came to Amritsar as a refugee. And the kind of violence which was shown in the film, that how a person who has been asked, or who has been forced to come from Pakistan, and who has come to India, and in those troubled times he was able to create some sort of a standing for himself. So Bhag Milkha Bhag became quite popular. It was directed by Rakesh Om Prakash Mehra, and this film became quite popular in that sense that it was dealing with the some sort of achievements of an Indian athlete. There was another film called Kya Dilli Kya Lahore, which was made by Vijay Raz, and this film which was also talking about two soldiers, those who have been left on the border, one an Indian soldier, another a Pakistani soldier, and both of them, they had origins in different countries. A Pakistani soldier with origins in India, and Indian soldier with origins in Pakistan, and how their life unfolds. Another film which I'd like to talk about is Bajrangi Bhaijaan, which was made in 2015, which is again dealing with the issue of love and brotherhood, and how a Pakistani girl who comes to India, she is being lost in India. And when she is being lost in India during that particular period, how her life might have changed, but because of one person who takes her back to Pakistan. And this film was a critique of the kind of hatred towards each other. And at the same time, film had a lot of appeal in that sense, that film was also talking about the commercialization of the news, that how news is being commercialized. And at the same time, film was also criticizing the establishment, that how the message of peace, love and brotherhood is more important, and how the establishment or the political situation is trying to create some kind of problems between the people. One thing I would like to talk about is the 1947 archive. 1947 archive is a new project which is trying to tackle the various issues which were related to the partition, and the various experiences of the people, those who were associated. So it is some sort of a global initiative in which life stories which were being shaped by the partition of India, they were to be shown, and how history would be recorded through the interviews would also be shown. How murder, rape and the kind of displacement, it shattered the families of the people, and how the memories of a shared partitioned past, they would also be shown. and how the potent memories from a divided India will be shown or will be in a way collected in the 1947 partition archive. So this has been an attempt so that the life stories of the people which were in a way associated with Pakistan, they will be exhibited during this particular period. In retrospect, we can say that partition indeed was a very tragic experience, not only for the people of India and Pakistan, but so many people, those who got displaced, how their experiences, they were being reflected. So one of the attempts has been the creation of the partition archive, where they will be able to record their own experiences. At the same time, the issue of communalism, which was closely associated with the partition theme, which we have already discussed, the kind of ideas with regard to the debates of the historians, that how historians they have debated on these various themes, how partition became inevitable, and how the media in the context of literature, in the context of films, in the context of paintings, how they have tried to project partition, and films they have done and some sort of a great contribution, that these moving images, they definitely have some kind of impact on the masses, as we have recently seen that a film like Bajrangi Bhaijaan became a hit. It was able to gross more than 500 crores, as has been reported. And this film, which is a very simple tale about the love and brotherhood of the masses and how people, they are same at different levels, be it in India and Pakistan, they share the same language, they share the same culture, and how they can prosper if they are living in communal harmony and if they are together. So all the shades of the partition of India in different films, where the experiences of partition from displacement, rootlessness, they have been exhibited in the various films which have been made in India, as well as some of the films which have been made in Pakistan. So I'd like to end the discussion here. Have a very good time. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. This was certainly extremely engaging and also informative at the same time. And we were able to gauge a lot of information, and of course, we'll be able to take it up as perhaps a subject of study also in the future for many students. So thank you so much, sir, for talking to us, and thank you, friends, for watching. Have a wonderful day.